Hello and welcome to a new LED circuits net project. In this project, I will show how to make a 36 output LED chaser circuit using NE555, CD4017, and CD4069 integrated circuits. Materials we will use: 1 piece NE555 timer, 6 pieces HCF4017, decade counter, 1 piece CD4069, hex inverter, 1 piece 10 kilo ohm resistor, 1 piece 1.5 kilo ohm resistor, 1 piece 100 kilo ohm Trimpot, 36 pieces 5mm LED. One piece 1 microfarad 16 volts capacitor. One piece 10 nanofarad ceramic capacitor. 5 pieces 1 N4148 diode. 1 piece 5 to 10 centimeters PCB board. Okay, let's get started. In this part of the series of electronic projects that I have prepared for beginners, I will show the LED chaser lights. You can find thousands of similar circuit diagrams on the internet, but for some reason, most circuits have 10 outputs. I thought about what could be done to increase the number of outputs, and here is the 36 outputs LED chaser. Isn't it cool? I designed it to have 48 outputs, but since 48 LEDs did not fit on the PCB I used, I had to use 36. If you want, you can make a 48 output LED chaser lights by using a 10 to 10 centimeters prototype PCB and adding one more CD4017. The LED chaser circuit consists of three parts. These are clock circuit, decade counter and LED driver circuit, and LED drivers control circuit. First of all, let's examine the integrated circuits we use in detail. If you know how the circuit parts work, you can skip this section. I built the clock circuit using the 555 integrated circuit. I explained in detail how it works in the previous video, so I will not show it again. If you haven't watched the video yet, I suggest you take a look. I created the decade counter and the LED driver circuit with CD4017. The CD4017 is a 5-stage Johnson counter IC and has 10 outputs. The operating voltage is between 3 to 20 volts. Q0, Q9 counts in decimals according to the pulses applied to inputs 4017. Clock, pin 14, clock inhibit, pin 13, and reset, pin 15. By connecting the carry-out output to other CD4017B ICs, you can continue counting in the decimal system. When clock inhibit and reset pins are in logic 0 state, if clock pulses are applied to clock, outputs Q0, Q9 are activated respectively. The counter stops if the clock inhibit input becomes logic 1, while clock pulses are applied to the clock input. Similarly, if the reset input changes to logic 1, the counter is reset and the outputs are cleared. Now, let's examine this information on the IC4017 test circuit that I built on the breadboard. In the first case, clock inhibit and reset pins are logic 0, as seen in the connection diagram. Every time I press the button connected to the clock pin, a pulse occurs and the output of the 4017 starts counting as Qn plus 1. As you press the button, the outputs of Q0, Q9 are activated one by one, and the count returns to the beginning after the last output is activated. The counts start to wait when the clock inhibit input is set to logic 1. As seen in the video, although I press the button and generate a pulse, the HCF4017 is waiting without reacting, but continues to activate its current output. In summary, CD4017 froze when the clock inhibit input was logic 1. I set it back to logic 0 to continue counting. Now, let's set the reset input to logic 1 level. Yes, as you can guess, the count has been reset, and we are back to the beginning. Also, the CD4017 is frozen again and does not respond at all. Finally, I want to show you something very interesting. In the CD4017 test circuit diagram, you have noticed that I use the 33 kilo ohm R2, R3, R4 resistors as pull up and pull down. When I did not add these resistors while running the circuit on the breadboard, an instability occurred. Also, when the C1100 nanofarad capacitor was not available, errors occurred due to the button arc. I noticed that when there is no pull-up resistor R2 connected to the clock input, it triggers itself when I touch the clock input with my finger. I've even triggered it from a distance, something like magic. We have another integrated circuit next. CD4069 is a hex inverter. The 4069 IC, which is very simple to use, transfers the logic level applied to its input in reverse to its output. For example, if the input is connected to logic 1 level, logic 0 levels are taken from the output. Conversely, when the input is logic 0, the output becomes logic 1. As seen in the circuit diagram, 4069 IC has 6 inverters. I set all the input sections to logic 1 and pull up with 33 kilo ohm resistor. Each input has a separate output. I connected the outputs with a 1.5 kilo ohm current limiting resistor to the anode terminal of the LED. I connected the cathode terminal of the LEDs to the negative terminal of the battery. Let's run our circuit on the breadboard. Yes, as you can imagine, none of the LEDs light up because the logic 1 applied to the input is inverted as logic 0 at the output. The LED did not light when logic 0 levels are applied to the anode of the LED. So what happens if the logic 0 levels are connected to the input? Let's try it now. Bingo! The output is logic 1. LED's anode is logic 1, its cathode is already connected to the negative terminal, and our LED started to light. I slightly changed the CD4069 test circuit. This time, I reversed some of the LEDs connected to the output section of the CD4069. Let's run the introduction part by applying logic 1, as in the previous circuit. Yes, you have learned how the CD4017 and CD4069 integrated circuits work. Now, I will explain in detail how the LED chaser light circuit works. There are a total of 6 CD4017s in the circuit. I run the LEDs of the LED chaser light circuit with 5 CD4017s. The 4017, which is the U1 code, controls the sequential operation of the other 4017 integrated circuits. Even though CD4017 is a decade counter, I can use only 8 outputs. When the circuit is energized and run, the Q0 outputs of the CD4017 integrated circuits become logic 1 level. Since NE555 operates in a steerable mode, it generates clock pulses whose duration can be adjusted with the Trimpot. The clock pulses are connected to the clock input pin of the other CD4017 integrated circuits, except U1. Clock inhibit and reset inputs are connected to the output terminals of the CD4069 integrated circuit. This way, we can control which CD4017 counter will be activated. So how do we control? Of course with the U1 4017 IC. When the circuit is energized, the Q0 outputs of all 4017s come to logic 1. The Q0 output of the U1 4017 integrated circuit is logic 1, the other outputs are logic 0. Logic 1 is inverted with the 4069 IC and becomes logic 0, thereby activating the U2 4017 IC. With the clock pulse generated by the NE555, U2 4017 continues to count. When the Q9 output is active and logic level 1, the pulse is sent to the U1 4017 integrated circuit via D1 diode, and the next output is activated. When the Q1 output of U1 4017 becomes logic 1, the U3 4017 integrated circuit starts counting. In this way, after completing the last CD4017 count, the Q5 output of U1 4017 goes to logic 1, and U1 is reset. Then it continues to count again and to activate the 4017s of the LEDs in sequence. Thanks for watching it. I hope it was useful. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and visit the links in the description box for the rest of the videos.